hard to believe here, but this season marks 15 years since the debut of The West Wing. And for lovers of politics, and the four of us all love this show, it's always among the most popular programs ever, in part because it starred what may be the best fictional president ever.
Honor thy father is the third commandment.
Then what's the first commandment?
I am the Lord your God. Thou shalt worship no other god before me. Boy, those were the days, huh? Mothers are standing in front of tanks. And we're going to go get their backs.
We cannot. We will not vote to keep on footing the bill. You will be held responsible for shutting down the federal government.
Then shut it down. One last thing. While you may be mistaking this for your monthly meeting of the ignorant, tight-ass club, in this building, when the president stands, nobody sits.
I think it would be appropriate at this time, Mr. President, to make a confession.
What's that?
I never voted for you.
Well, thanks for trying, but here I am anyway. In the future, if you're wondering, crime, boy, I don't know, is when I decided to kick your ass.
The U.S. is trampling on the sovereignty of my country, and on behalf of President Enzilu,
I've just taken your airport. You'll denounce these people, Al. You'll do it publicly. And until you do, you can all get your fat asses out of my White House. CJ, show these people out.
I believe we can find the door.
I could watch these clips all night. And now it's not just Jed Bartlett. There are a whole lot of fictional presidents, some a little contrived, but also some that get you fired up and inspired. And I think it's made it harder for some of the real presidents to measure up.
Get off my plane.
With every child, we comfort and then teach to rejoice in what we have been re-given.
We're going to survive. Today, we celebrate our Independence Day.
If you want to talk about character and American values, fine. Just tell me where and when and I'll show up. This is a time for serious people, Bob, and your 15 minutes are up. My name is Andrew Shepherd and I am the president.
Oh, for one was that, it was so easy, right? If you had the dramatic music that followed you whenever you came in,
great.
Right?
That close up, you know?
But seriously, is there an element, everybody knows there's TV and everything else, but people expect larger-than-life figures. I mean, even during the campaign that was largely a TV special for President Obama, some argued, real governing's a lot harder than Hollywood makes it. In some ways, have the public's expectations gotten a little overly inflated?
I think they probably have. Yeah, I really do, because each of those movies, I mean, where's the president fighting the bad guys on Air Force
One?
One
of them fought aliens, by the way. You know, he got in a fighter jet Independence Day, but yeah.
I always marveled at that. Yeah.
You did that once, though, right? In IAC, right? You got in a fighter jet?
Right. Yeah, flying around. And they filmed it, too.
Yeah,
it's perfect.
Yeah, exactly.
Now, I think people do. But, of course, the reality is that we don't see a lot behind the scenes. So that's why West Wing was so much fun, because he had, in that show, he had his vulnerabilities, you know. And you could see he was really trying. He had real tough issues from time to time, which is the reason I love that show
He was a real person. He had flaws. He had all that. Yeah. He had challenges. But the idea, Andrew, that it was a war of ideas that we saw in all these things, and it was concepts. The public now says it's not about ideas. It's about the petty partisan bickering. It's about dysfunction and everything else. I know it's a movie. I'm not trying to make it what it wasn't, or a TV series, albeit a great one. There is something to it, right?
It played to the better angels of our nature, because most of the characters in it were doing it out of pure purposes, that they legitimately thought they were doing the right thing or what was in the best interest of the country. And it wasn't just for petty political gain. And we see so much of that play out in real life. Mr. County Executive, I'm curious, though. Did you ever get staffers who started in government who thought maybe it would be a lot like The West Wing or a lot like one of these movies that they saw, only to realize, boy, this is not nearly as exciting, or maybe more exciting?
No, actually, the staffers are the one who enjoyed the show the most, and people who would come in, because although it's not of that caliber, okay, but the similarities in trying to make a deal to get something passed or some having to deal with a rogue legislator, or trying to deal with a major issue of life and death, which does happen.
Yep.
The constant flow of information and the pettiness. You know, then in between there, you've got these, why are we dealing with this subject kind of thing? And that's why The West Wing was so much fun. And I, literally, the staffers would talk about it every day, every morning
afterwards. What was Andrew's Big Cheese? What was that one?
Big Cheese Day, yeah. Big Cheese Day,
right.
With their,
we have to deal with some of those ancillary issues. I think Andrew's right. I've seen a lot of people come in starry-eyed, and they said, oh, you know, when's the big moment here? When are the French doors going to fly open, and we're going to have that dramatic
scene? In journalism, too. Everybody thinks it's going to be like, you know.
Woodward and Bernstein, absolutely,
right.
Yeah.
But now, you guys might call me a groupie, but...
Oh, we will.
And a lot worse.
Yes, go ahead.
But with President Clinton, especially, and with President Obama, I'm making personal observations from seeing them up close. They are larger than life figures. I mean, I still get chills, no matter who the president is, President Bush, whoever. And I don't know how you guys feel about this, but when the lights are on, all the lights in the room, and the podium's there, and then all of a sudden you hear dun 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 dun, dun and ladies and gentlemen, the president. And they walk out. I mean, they're very magical.
I got you beat in that I once met many years ago Dan Quayle, who even then was a punchline, okay? So you'd say to yourself, this one ain't exactly like, you know, JFK's walking in the room. But there's something that happens when you hear.
Yes.
I mean, and it's not just the, you know, from the executive office, but when they walk in, the room feels different, yet nobody sits down, and that was made for TV.
Right.
You're all standing, there is that aura, and that possibility of something. I'm not trying to be too Pollyannish here, but there still is that thing, and sometimes they get it right, not when they're fighting aliens and the president's literally in a fighter jet, but they can capture it, you know? And that's where you got into the business in the first place, right?
Absolutely. I mean,
to fight aliens.
Well, I haven't found any yet. I'm looking.
God knows he's looking. Yeah,
but no, I mean that's one of the reasons, and it's true. You know, you're with that stature. When I met President Clinton the first time, he's the president of the United States. There's nothing. Yeah. You know, that's the largest and most powerful position, and no matter how you look at it, and forget all of the various jeeps and the guns and the security, he's a president of the United States, and it really does it. And so to allow us to come and see just a little bit, maybe not Air Force One so much, but in those kinds of movies where you get a chance to see maybe how they do really act in there, it's good.
It is. All right, we're going to take a quick break, everybody. We'll be right back.